Hello, welcome back. Last time Wilko Johnson was on the sofa, he was coming to terms with what was thought to be terminal cancer. But after recording his final album and going on a farewell tour, he is back, we're glad to say, with much better news.
Yeah, the former Dr. Feelgood guitarist was initially given just 10 months to live after refusing chemotherapy, but had radical surgery later to remove the tumour. Now he's been declared cancer-free.
Very good morning to you. It's lovely to see you. We'll talk to you in a minute. First of all, we're going to hear some of that so-called last album recorded with The Who's Roger Daltrey.
Honest stuff. Morning, Wilko.
Morning.
Well, if this is a great... surprise, but also a wonderful thing to be able to do, to talk to you on the sofa again.
Thank you.
Really wonderful. How did it come about? Because I've heard you talking in the past about how you were, you know, accepting of what was going to happen to you, and now it's an entirely different story.
Well, at the beginning of last year, as you said, I was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer and told this was inoperable, there was nothing they could do, and that I had about 10 months to live. I, apart from this lump that was growing in my stomach, I felt fine. So I thought, okay, I'm going to go. But I decided to do a farewell tour, and just carried on playing and carried on and carried on. The summer came. I'm still on my feet doing festivals. It's coming to when it was coming towards the end of last year, the end of my time. Roger Daltrey got in touch with me and said he would like to do this album together. I said, well, we better do it quick, man, because, you know. And we did, actually. We made it in about 8 days.
Right.
And just after we'd done this, this character, Charlie Chan, that I know, he's a photographer, but he's also a cancer doctor. And he was becoming curious, this is early this year, as to why I was still alive. And he asked me to go and see his friend, Mr. Emmanuel Hugay, who's a consultant at Addenbrooke's Hospital, see what he thought about it. And he looked at me and ran all the tests again and everything and said he thought they could operate and do it. By this time, this tumour, which had started out about that size here, was...
Gosh.
Big, right? I mean, it was going on.
I've heard you describe.
I was going on stage, and my guitar was actually rocking on this
goodness.
Bump.
You know? What an extraordinary thing.
I still felt the rest of me felt fine still.
Right.
And so I said, well, go ahead. I'm already in extra time, and I went in. This is in April.
Right.
They operated and took this thing out along with other bits and pieces of me. But they took it out and then.
How much did it weigh? The
tumour weighed 3 kilos.
Goodness!
This is the size of a baby. As I say, I was going to thing rocking about, and I mean, and I was. Some weeks in hospital, I suffered from secondary infections after the operation, and then in June, I think it was, I went home, and like, oh man, I was so weak. I'm so weak. I'm exercising by trying to walk round the block of an evening, you know, and I'm kind of hanging onto the walls and puffing and panting. And I didn't think I'd ever get well, but Mr. Hugay, the surgeon, was—he was constantly on the phone to me, and you know, and he says, "Don't worry, it will come back, it will come back." And yes, now it is coming back, and I think I'm almost maybe 80-90% back.
Extraordinary kind of series of events. So how?
Well, it is. I mean, the whole thing was. The whole couple of years have been strange.
Yeah. How are you now, sort of physically?
Physically, I'm pretty fit. I don't know if I could run 100 metres or anything.
Right.
But, I will.
But I was enormously struck at the time about how positive you were, saying, well, if this is going to be the end, this is the end. You felt more alive than before. And now what do you think?
Well, actually, yeah, it's strange. I mean, when I got the diagnosis, it's a peculiar thing, you know, you're sitting there and there's a doctor there and he says those words to you. Oh. You've got cancer. It takes a second and boom, the universe has changed. Now, when he said this to me, I felt absolutely calm. It didn't freak me out. It was as if he was telling me something I'd known all my life. And I remember walking out of the hospital. It was a very beautiful winter's day, looking up at the sky and seeing the trees against the sky and thinking, oh, God, I'm alive. Mm. And I was high. And to such an extent, I thought this must be delayed shock or something. Mm. And but this feeling continued. And I don't know, that it was a marvellous year.
And you still feel marvellous now,
yeah,
even better.
Yeah,
though.
But see, coming back again, it's like, as I say, there was this ordeal of this operation, and this ages and ages lying on a bed full of tubes and things, you know. And now, my mind is still getting used to the idea that life goes on, you know. Yeah.
Let's see, we want to talk about the music. Should we just have a listen to another track from the album? This is Going Back Home.
That's fun looking at all that footage as well. And what's really clear, which is lovely seeing you today and Ollie Mears as well, for example, you know, you are inspiring people still, your music, which is fantastic.
Yes, so they say.
Why do you think what is it? Is it something special that you were doing, do you think, or are doing?
I really don't know. I mean, well, I've always known there are many people that, you know, kind of followed our lead from the 70s when,
yes,
I was in Dr. Feelgood, and I think we kind of stirred things up a bit, and many people got started from there. You know, many of the people in the punk movement and that got their inspiration, I think, from what we were doing. Mm. I mean, we didn't do it to inspire people. We just did it to have a good time.
You had a farewell tour. Mm. So are you going to have a sort of welcome back tour now?
Well, hopefully. I'm not quite sure. You know, I want to get playing again. Mm. And I think that will be possible, yeah, soon in the new year.
Can you play at home, as it were, now? Are you playing at home? Or?
I'll never do that.
Really?
I'm telling you what, I never pick my guitar up and until I walk on stage.
Oh my goodness,
you know,
amazing.
I'm not a musician, I think I'm a performer.
But yeah. But hang on a second, your fingers must get stiff if you don't pick up a guitar every once in a while.
Well, I mean, actually, because... I mean, for 40 years now, mm, I'm constantly playing. This being in hospital and recuperating has been taken up a large part of this year.
Of course.
I've never been so long without playing,
mm, right,
you know, so... I've got, you know, there's a slight apprehension about, you know, can I still do it?
Well, it'd be great, because I'm sure all those people there who said goodbye to you on the last tour will be desperate to come back and say hello again to you.
Well, I hope they do. Yeah. Yes.
Oh,
Wilko,
nice,
it's a huge pleasure to see you.
Thanks
so much.
Thank you very much. Wilko's album is called Going Back Home. Thank you.
We've got to go back home now. Sally and I will be...